Hey guys, and welcome back to Minecraft. Today I want to do something a little bit different. I've been wanting to talk with you guys for a bit instead of just kind of doing like building and building and doing that kind of stuff. So I figured today I've been running low on resources, so it's a great opportunity for us to go do some caving and just kind of talk and gather some resources and stuff. And so throw my shulker boxes and say, I guess we don't need good old Choppy there. I'll just bring this stuff for defense, bring some wood in case we need more torches. But yeah, so I figured we could just kind of talk and chill today, and I guess we'll bring our buckets. Probably a safe bet. But anyway, so figured we could just kind of talk, chill, and hang out, and just kind of go over how I like to build, because I've had a few people ask just kind of different things and different tips about like the style and how that's all coming along. So I figured today could be a good opportunity to kind of just talk about that while I just go and do random stuff. And I believe there's a cave down here that I found that looked pretty decent, and I'm hoping it's big enough. Yeah, this guy. So we got a bit of a drop to go down though, so that kind of sucks. Might want to end up turning off the shaders down here. But let's, yeah. We'll figure our way out later. See if we. Oh, there's some coal down there already, so that's nice. Yeah, so, well, we got a silk pick and just a regular pick. So, what I like to do when caving is actually just kind of go out and scout up ahead a little bit, then come back and pick up things. We're just gonna throw these in our offhand for now and start picking up all this good stuff. But, anyways, guys, so kind of what I wanted to get to is, again, like I was saying, how I build and all that good stuff. So, I guess my main thing I like to look at when building is trying to keep the structures really organic shaped and kind of not that usual 3x3 basis or anything like that. You see a lot of builds kind of going in, especially in survival. I like to keep that really consistent. Oh, stupid skeleton. Got me in a freaking cobweb. Yeah, this could be a little dangerous while talking and doing this, but you know, we'll be fine. We're down here to get coal and iron and all that fun stuff. Anyways, kind of going back to it, like really big organic shapes like you see with me doing in that farmhouse that was kind of along the edge of the road there, where we kind of worked with the shape of the wall that we're building, like the border to the field. Just trying to really work with the shaping and work with all that so that we can get a good kind of organic shape to it that really flows with the land instead of kind of having all these shapes that just kind of are there and really look like somebody just kind of plopped down and built this thing there instead of really thinking about like what the environment was and what they're trying to do and working with the terrain. So I always try and work with the terrain and work with just different things like that. Like what makes it look like this would make sense here? Like how realistic does this make it look? And does this actually, like, say I'm putting a farmhouse in? I wouldn't put a farmhouse in the middle of, like, just like a ditch or something like that. I'd try and keep it kind of up so it wouldn't flood, wouldn't do all that kind of stuff. Because a lot of the area here is about irrigation and just kind of keeping everything. I guess, like, you got to think about where the water would be going. So you really get, I really try and look at all of the different ways that the water would be flowing down the hill, and I'd try and put the farmhouse in somewhere that wouldn't be interacting with that. Like it would be, or you can re, or if you really want to, you can reorganize the terrain so that the farmhouse actually runs, like, or so the house or whatever you're trying to build works with the terrain where you want it to go. But that adds a little bit more effort, and I think it's more fun to build with the vanilla terrain. So I try and do that all the time. Yeah, regular picky. And then beyond that, so we got our organic shapes, and then from there we kind of go into like I really enjoy working with odd numbers, especially because the roof is a lot easier. It looks a lot less derpy, and then interiors kind of they don't look like you have to make the interior just kind of look the same on both sides. It gives you a lot more room to work with if you do like a 5 wide home or something like that, because then you have 3 blocks in the middle, or I like to do usually a little bit larger, so it's about 7 blocks wide, so we have 5 blocks to work with in the middle, and then it just gives you that little extra bit of space, and you can use trapdoors in there to create extra walls and divide up the rooms. And a lot of the stuff is very freeform. Like there's not anything that's really just kind of like looks very static and the same across all of the different builds. A lot of the stuff is just kind of built just for that build. It's very much just kind of working with what we have around it, and I try and not copy anything, so every single build is unique and interesting. Versus a lot of what I really dislike is when people build the same like L-shaped house that has a 3x3 area, then another 3x3, and then like off to the left or the right, there's like a third room that's 3x3 or like 1x3. Just I feel like that really kind of puts you in this little bit of a rut that just is not that good or makes builds really, really boring. Like you're trying to make the goal here is to make something that's really interesting to look at and really interesting for people to go and check out. So it's always good when you can kind of just when every single house looks like you, of course you want the style to be the same, but you can make every house have its own unique personality because like say a different person built it or something like that. Like it's never going to be the same guy who built every single house. Unless you have one mason, and then of course it makes sense to have a lot of similar characteristics to it. But all in all, every single house is going to be pretty different from each other, especially because the family who lives in it, like when we're doing a small hamlet, most of the houses were probably built by the people who live in them. So they're going to have their own styles, what they're able to use, what materials they had on hand, and what they could afford to work with, and what then, like the purpose of building the house. Pretty big opening over there. But so more like I guess what I like to avoid is like I said working with the 3x3 shapes, 1x3 shapes, and oh, freaking creeper. I hate creepers so much. But like yeah, so like 3x3, 1x3, 5x3, those types of shapes, like you can work with them, but they shouldn't be everywhere in the build. Like if that is the whole purpose of the build, or that if that is the whole way you're designing the house, I feel like it's really kind of counterintuitive, or it really goes against creativity because you're really stuck in those rigid different shapes, designs, and things that just like anybody can do that. That's kind of how I view it. If anybody can do it, then if I'm trying to make an interesting channel for people to come and check out, like why should I be doing that more or less? Ooh, that's a creeper. Where is he? Where is the guy? Yeah. That's kind of what I think about when I'm trying to build something like is would somebody be interested in looking at this? Like is this something that like stands out? Like if you have enough if you have a lot of people's different farmhouses right next to each other. So I'm using farming as such a big example. That is what I'm building right now. Is the farm hamlet. So like what makes your build stand out from everybody else's? Like why should somebody spend the time looking at your place versus the person right next door? Or versus the build right next door? Like that's what I really try and think of. Like so in that, like a lot of people like watching the tutorial videos and things like that, and like here's a block by block way of building this house. And I really try and avoid doing those. As you guys have probably noticed, I haven't done one of those yet, but we've done quite a few of, oh, let's build this together, let's see what goes and kind of how it turns out. That's kind of, ooh, thought that was something. Oh, no, I want. Damn it. Always forget the silk pick. But that's kind of what I try and avoid doing because I don't want to give you guys builds that you can just be like, all right, I know that's like a way to get quick subs, and that's what every big YouTuber kind of does. It's kind of like Minecraft YouTuber, at least, is just kind of like, oh, well, you know, you can just give them tutorials on how to build it, and then they can do it themselves, and then they get what they want, and they leave. And then usually, like, oh, that house that I built was pretty cool. Let's go check out that guy's channel, see what other house he can teach me how to build. But I really try and avoid doing those. And I think there's a spawner up here. So many zombies. Jeez, what is this? What is good? All right, well, there has to be a spawner up here somewhere. Maybe? No? Maybe just a lot of zombies. Oh, hi, Mr. Creeper. Yes. All right. Let's grab this stuff up here, and then we can go venture out a little bit more. Yeah, so like I'm saying, so I'm kind of all over the place. I haven't really done a video like this before, so it's just kind of me giving it a shot and see how it goes, and I hope you guys enjoy it. But just kind of talking about what I think of when I'm building and what I think of when I'm actually doing things and giving me more practice of talking while actually doing stuff. So I hope that kind of makes sense. So kind of moving on to the next thing I wanted to talk about today is like how large you make the structure versus what you have planned for the interior. Because I get it, it's all really easy to make a giant structure and add a lot of detail to the outside because that's just easier. You have a lot more blocks to work with, so you have a lot more designs you can work with. But that being said, I've seen a lot of people do that, making these like say massive farmhouses or something for like a little wheat field, and that just obviously doesn't make sense when you're looking at it. I love this bow. I got this bow through fishing. I fished up a bow, and then I got Power 5, Infinity, and Flame books while I was doing it. So I was just like, damn, all right, well, I guess I don't need a bow for the future. But yeah, so let's see what. Oh, there's some iron right there. Cool. Yeah, so back to talking about building and things like that. Kind of really working with how large of an interior you want to go, it just kind of goes into that planning phase. Like, I don't like to build anything without even like thinking about like, okay, this house, how many people are going to live in it? How many rooms do I want to have? What, like, how wealthy is the person? Like, how is every room just going to be a bedroom or some type of storage room? Or are they going to have like a sitting room and all that different like fancy types of rooms and things like that that you wouldn't find in like a small culture area? All right, I'm pretty lost. I don't know where we've been and where we haven't. But kind of like, whoa, hello. Yep, creeper. But like I was saying, a lot of the times I try and avoid going from that small. Is that? Oh. I try and avoid going from the type of. What is over there? What the hell? I don't like that drop. I try and avoid from making too large of interiors basically for the size, or too large of rooms for the basically the size that I want the. Ooh, that's we're gonna avoid that for now. For basically for the size that I want the family to be, I try and actually really cram a lot of that detail through the texturing and things like that to make the walls and whatnot interesting versus going and trying to make like this really awesome exterior to the house and it's like, well, now I have this big like 14 by 14 wall that's just flat and like the rooms are just giant and what do I fill it with? And then a lot of times like even if you're in that case, that's when you just need to kind of buckle down and create walls on the interior to add like hallways and different smaller rooms. Oh, that's not safe. What do we have on us? Do we have any moves? All right, we can use that. Never mind, we actually have no way of getting blocks below. But yeah, so like a big thing I see a lot of people doing that I really try and avoid, and I think it's a good practice to get into avoiding, is the just kind of avoiding going from working with giant exteriors and making these huge roofs, which waste a lot of materials, because as we all have probably seen, if you guys have been playing survival alongside, clay is hard as hell to find, but it makes great roofs. So, oh, buy iron. It's really like, I don't know how to say it, but it just like works a lot better for the way I like to build, at least, to make smaller rooms, smaller interiors, and then kind of like plan out the base floor pattern for how it's going to be and how large I want each room to be. And then build up the walls and then build up the roof and that kind of stuff. Then, like, I figure out if I want a second story there. And then that kind of just leads into how much do I actually want. And just kind of really gives a better idea in the end for what I want to see and what I want to accomplish out of the build. Then I feel like I can get just kind of planning this large exterior. I kill it. I think I got him. Oh yeah, I did. Cool. Then planning like the large exterior and then being like, oh wait, we don't want that. Like, I think it just works a lot better to plan kind of the shape of the house you want and kind of where you're going with it and the end goal before you just kind of start placing blocks down and being like, oh, I want a big house here. Like, let's just start building and see where it goes. I like to at least like have some sort of a plan or anything really, just kind of letting me know where I want to go with it and kind of what we want to be doing and the whole thing. One quick sec here, guys. All right, and we're back. Just had to change up a quick thing there. All right, so we can grab this coal, hopefully, right here. And Yeah, cool. Not gonna die to anything. Anything over here that we can find? Alright, so that's where that was. What's this? That's a dead end. I guess we kind of have to go this way. I do want to be able to find like a different thing other than this chasm, because mining in chasms is a pain. Let's see what's going on over here. Now, right, where can we get out? I guess let's go back up on this guy. Right. Yeah, let's grab up this coal. We can grab stuff pretty quick. Yeah, we can jump right up there. Oh no! Oh, God. Pork chop so we can heal up. But yeah, so kind of back to what we were talking about with all of the kind of how you want to take your design, in my opinion. I really enjoy doing the free form. I really enjoy making the design up as I, more or less as I go, as I plan out what the house or whatever we're trying to build here is supposed to do, like what is the purpose of it, and then we can more decide on how do we want to design it. Because like say you're trying to build a storage place, yeah, you want it to be really large, yeah, you want to have a lot of different area to store all these open chests and things like that. But that being said, like you also want to be watching for what the shape is going to be compared to everywhere else, because I've seen quite a few builds from like big YouTubers and whatnot who like they play Minecraft and show off their builds and things like that, but everything kind of turns out into these different like version of a square basically. Instead of like having its own unique shape and design, it's like, well, I have all these different compartments and things that I just add together whenever I need a new build. Versus like here, I feel like we're really trying to make all these unique designs that actually are like interesting to check. Oh God. Oh man, it's a lot of crap. But like making interesting designs that we can actually use and actually, sorry, I'm blanking right here. I keep saying agenda on the map, right? Oh, where'd you come from? Look, did anybody else see that? It looked like you dropped from the ceiling. All right, well, let's grab up this coal and get out of here. I don't like this spot. Right, well, there's that, and I think there's something behind me. No, I'm just crazy. It's fine. But yeah, guys, so let's just keep mining a little bit here and see what's down this way. I think this will be the last hallway we explore, but let me know what you guys are thinking about all this kind of stuff that I usually think about. Like I'm curious to see, like when you guys are designing something, what do you think about? Like where do you get your inspiration from? What do you do? Like I know a lot of people check out like history books and things like that and find the shape of different structures and oh God, and just build off of what they see and what they see online. Or but then there's a lot of times people will see something online and be like, that looks really cool, I want to duplicate that 100%. Versus being like, all right, well, that was an interesting idea. How can I expand on it? Like, what part of it do I find interesting that I want to take into my own build? Versus kind of being like, all right, I want this whole thing right here. This is like perfect. This is everything I could ever imagine needing for my build, and this is exactly what I want to look like and be right there. Like, what do you guys more go for that style, or do you try and make your own different versions, I guess? Like, do you take somebody's build and kind of see it and be like, all right, I want that exactly? Or do you actually just kind of be like, okay, that's a cool way of doing a roof. Let's see what. Ooh, emerald. I don't think I've got one of these for a long ass time. Ooh, quite a few emeralds. I guess we must be under the mountains then. I need a spider eye. Let's go check out what's down here. But yeah, so I'm really curious to see what you guys have to say about it. I've like getting these discussions going with you guys so I can share my opinion and then actually like hear what you guys think about it. I think it's a cool way. We have so much freaking coal. This is great. We're never gonna need coal again. But yeah, so it's just a I think it's a cool way for us to interact, and then I can actually get like the more boring parts of the survival, which are running through caves and mining and grabbing all the resources and things. Like we can actually make that interesting by having conversations while it's going on. But if you guys are into this kind of stuff, please let me know. I think I'm going to end it here. That's about all I have time for today, guys. I do hope you enjoyed, and remember to hit that like and subscribe button down below. Let me know in the comments below about what you thought about the video, and I will see you guys next time.